Welcome to another Airbrush Asylum tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how I airbrushed this Lucky 13 skull using the AirShot template that you can see behind me. So let's get into the tutorial right now. Okay, so I'm going to use the template now, just line that up. Now it's going to chop off a little bit of the template, but that's okay. I might just lift it up a little bit here so you get a bit more of the beard in. Okay, so just want to line that up and then tack that into place just so it doesn't move. Now with some paper masks, just protect that side. Same again on the other side. And now I'm going to go ahead and use that transparent black, and that's going to give us a basic outline. If I've got a little bit of that texture showing through, that's fine. The reason I'm going transparent black is because it isn't as harsh as a regular black. I just want to get a basic outline, and then I can further shade and add highlights and stuff as I go to further build the artwork. So that should be enough. There we have it. Ready to go and detail the artwork. Okay, so now I'm going to use a white. I'm going to start to detail the artwork. And essentially this is going to be the foundation. You can start to leave some of that grey and black showing. So from the template, it looks to be that it's suggestive of a highlight on the top right. So we'll try and stick with that. The idea is not to go too smooth. And I'm thinking of adding some color as well. So hence why I'm using that white base. That'll allow the color to pop, and then I can tone things down as I go along. This is basically my underpainting. So you can see how I'm just hitting certain parts of those teeth, not going over the entire tooth, leaving some some shadows in there, just hitting out some of those highlights. So that's what's going to give you the dimension. And if you're not confident doing it freehand, then by all means go grab the template, come back in and use that to get your sharp edges. But I'm not too concerned at this stage. I just want to get a basic outline happening. Like I said, this is just the underpainting. Texture on here. I don't want smooth skin for obvious reasons. And we'll start putting some strands in for the beard. So really just fine, quick dagger strokes to achieve the look of the beard. Again, if you struggle with trying to get some of these finer strands in there, grab yourself a fine art brush, that'll work. Or if you're working on, say, synthetic paper or something like that, then all you need to do is do it with a blade, which makes life a lot easier. So again, building up more brightness on this side. and using my fire tool template set, the mini version, I'm just going to pick out some of these sharp edges for the monocle. Again, using the template to get a few of those real sharp reflections in there. Okay, so now time to render the hat. Grab that texture template again and add a little bit of texture in the hat. So it's a pretty simple one to do. Now just to get that lucky 13 back in there, I'm going to utilize the template for this, which will make it easier. So just line up all of the bits that you can actually see. I will go freehand over the top. I just want to get the general shape in there with the use of the template. Flip it back so that you can see through. And then I'm going to spray a bit heavier through it this time. Again, I can tweak it as I go. But that should give us a better indication, which it does. And then I can render that even more. So what I'm going to do now is color that in with the white. The reason being is I want that glowing. You can see that white's running reasonably thin. I have over-reduced it as I normally would. So I've just moved to this top part of the three so that the bottom section there can dry off a little bit more. And I'll come back to it now and go over the top. So I'm just avoiding it from spidering out on me. Okay, so I've got that nice and bright now, which is cool. Brighten up some more of these highlights on the hat. And then start adding some color. So you notice I haven't drawn around the 3D element of the Lucky 13, because like I said, I want it to look like it's glowing. And just brighten this up a little bit as well. A bit more texture. Remember, you can always dull down texture as well. So don't be afraid to add some, and if you think it's it's too much, then eliminate it. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead now and using a flesh tone, I'm gonna color in the hat. Now, if you wanna see how to easily mix up a flesh tone similar to this, I'll pop a link in the description below to a video showcasing how to do it. Now, because this is an opaque flesh tone, you are going to lose a bit of that texture detail that I added. But I'm not too worried about that at this point. If you're really concerned about it, then just leave gaps. So like so, and don't go as heavy. And you're still going to be able to see a little bit of that texture through there. I'm trying to control my overspray here. I'm not being too careful. So I am getting a bit of that overspray from the flesh on those numbers, but that's fine. I'll go back in with the white before I add the glow. Same thing here, this is the darker area, so I'm just going to dust that in. But I do want to get a bit of this colour on there for the hat, and then I can shade back over it. Okay, almost done with this colour. Get a little bit of rendering on the straps as well of the monocle. It's probably not accurate, but I needed something there. I'll just change that up a little bit. I'll sort of make it look like it's part of some sort of mechanism holding that all into place. I could shade back over that anyway later, but it is a fantasy illustration, so doesn't have to be 100% true to life. Put your own spin to it. Okay, so now I'm going to further detail with sepia. Start to really add some detail into the hat now. Add all my distressing back into it. This is where you can grab that texture template again and come back in and add some more textures throughout. This won't be the final tone. I'm also going to come in with the transparent black. But you'll see how this is already starting to shape it. So once I put that transparent black on and the highlights, it'll really give it that 3D appearance and make it pop. If this is the first time watching one of our videos, then welcome. For all of our regular viewers, welcome back. I do hope that you're enjoying this video tutorial so far. If you are, by all means, give it the thumbs up, share it out, and let's build this airbrushing community together. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing, tap on that bell icon, and that'll notify you every time I put out new content. Ratty up some of these edges. You work up close and pull back heavily on the trigger, you get those wetter spots. It'll blow out on you, which is also a cool way to build some texture. Do it deliberately. Almost done with his sepia. Few more deliberate spiders to dirty up that hat. Okay, so using that white, I want to brighten up the 13 again before I hit it with the color to make it glow. Okay, so now I want to add the color, and I'm adding fluoro green. You can see how bright that is straight over the white. That's why it's important to have a nice bright white base. So you can also use fluoro colors and add them into your existing color to make it brighter. It works really well. Or use them as an underpainting and then paint over the top, which is kind of like what I'm going to do in a minute here. Just want to get this nice and bright. Give it another coat. The only thing you need to remember with fluoros is that they have a tendency to fade if they're used for exterior applications. So keep that in mind if you're going to utilize fluoro colors on, say, your car bonnet or hood for all of our overseas viewers. There's a good chance it'll fade out. Okay, so now I'm going to use the same tone for the skull. Obviously now I'm getting overspray in sections, but I'm going to come back in and highlight and also add in some darker shading to bring out all the detail again. You don't have to follow this colour combination either. You can do whatever you like. Be as creative as you want to be with it. It's the whole point of the template. Basically there to help you to get the outline really quickly and sketched on, and then you can tweak the artwork whichever way you like. I just thought this would be a fun combination of colours. Okay, so now it's time to come back in with some highlights. And then I'll finish off with my transparent black. So you don't want to go over everything again. I'm just picking out some of these highlights because I don't want to eliminate all the green. Just want to further shape it. So it should be a lot quicker for you to finish this step as opposed to the previous white that we used. Adding in those strands of the beard. Doing a bit of a dot highlight on here, on the strap. Now working on the hat. So really take your time with the white, build it up. Always let my white build. So moving over the stroke a few times to brighten it up a bit, and then attacking another area, and then sometimes even coming back to work back over the top of it and re-brighten it. Try to keep your white controlled as well so it sits over the lighter sections if you can. I'm going to come in and hit some of these edges really bright. Okay, so now I'm gonna come in with the transparent black and further detail. So now you really want to be sharp with it. You can see I'm feathering out some of that black to cut in around the Lucky 13 skull. And I'll blend that out. I'll probably even use some of the texture templates. Do that a bit later. I just want to get in all this detail. So cutting in nice and sharp around the eye. So as you can see, I'm just fading out off that edge, and then I'll come in with that texture template and tie it all in. It's just an easy way to clean up the edges rather than having to go back and mask over them. Darkening off this side a little bit more in accordance with the light source that I've chosen. Again, you can totally switch up your light source. It doesn't have to be the same as this. Texturing or stippling under here where those dagger strokes meet the bottom of that jaw. Just going to cut this in a little bit more to match up with the other side. I feel it's a bit wide. So you can see I'm always moving with my airbrush, and when I'm trying to do those real sharp shadows, I'm kind of locking in my elbows and also looking ahead of my line. So when I'm moving along here, my eyes are here. Because then naturally the airbrush tends to follow. So shading heavier on this side of the hat to create that 3D effect. And I'll also shade around the edge, and then we'll bring that grunge back in. Okay, so now utilizing the grunge template, just gonna spray along that edge, and it'll make it appear as though that grunge is going back into the original light gray grunge that I did. We just got that different contrast now where it's going from black into the grunge back into that gray. Just a quick way of how to clean up any overspray, give the artwork a little bit more depth, and also blend it back into the existing background without having to spend all that time masking it. And with masking, obviously, you're going to get a real defined edge. So by doing it this way, you avoid that. Obviously, if you want the defined edge, that's fine, and go ahead and mask it. But I just want to show you some easy technique that you can use. Now we're going to just bring a little bit of that over the top, so that it merges into the existing tone. So I'm just going to come out a little bit further with it, varying the grunge that I use. And you can also lift it if you want to get that softer effect. Okay, so now a bit of shading. Just brightening up a couple of the highlights. Especially on that leading edge closest to our light source. few dot white highlights just to pick up some of those real bright spots within the eye. I want to add a bit more glow around it, so I'm going to just deliberately spray outside of the numbers. Okay, so I feel this needs a little bit more contrast, so I'm going to go ahead and shade it with some red violet. Going back over it to brighten it up a little bit more and just feathering it off, so I'm not coating straight over the top of all that highlight that I did earlier. I'll just leave that a bit lighter like so, and now we've got a little bit more contrast in that spot. So I'll just come back in and throw a couple of those highlights back over it. Again, if you're happy with it the way it is, that's fine, leave it. And it doesn't take much. Less is more. So here is the completed canvas. See all the detail now. The grunge in the background. So loads of fun to do. and be sure to check out some of the other videos and playlists that I've got listed here. Until next time, go grab your airbrush, do some amazing artwork yourself, and I'll see you again very, very soon in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.